So for the shareholders, the UAE rollout is transformational. The AEG is shifting from development stage renewables player into an owner of the mission-critical digital infrastructure with a constructed recurring revenues. So the models provide scalability, defensibility, and exposure of two of the fastest-growing technology sectors globally.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is Aleksandra Tsybulskaya, General Manager for Active Energy Group in the UAE. Alexa, very good to meet you. Construction started in the first 8 MW in the UAE. What progress has been made on site, and what's the expected timeline?
Hello, thanks you for having me today. So the groundworks has been completed and the site now is moving into the equipment installation phase. The power connection has already been approved by the electrical authority. So we are planning to deliver everything in the initial phase on the timeline. So we expect the commissioning to take place during the first half of 2026, with the first tenants going live shortly thereafter.
You've applied to expand the site to 33 megawatts and you plan to reach 100 megawatts next year. How will you fund and deliver that growth?
So the pathway is clearly phased already. So we have 8 MW under construction and 25 MW is under the application. Negotiations well advanced on the further 60 MW, which is taking place just right now. Funding is expected to be a combination of the project finance, infrastructure leasing agreements with the tenants, and selective equity supports where all of the value accredited selected investors will be there. It's very important because the AG, we retain the ownership of the infrastructure and secure long-term rental revenues. So we can leverage the contracted cash flows to support the further expansion.
Alexa, ultra-low-cost energy is described as your unique selling point. How does this advantage translate into margins, return on investment, and long-term competitiveness?
So accessing the surplus energy in the UAE provides us with the costs which are among the lowest globally. For the tenants such as AI data operators and Bitcoin miners, energy represent the single largest cost input, which is about 60-70% of the operation expenses. So by providing energy at the fraction in the global averages, we can offer the very highly competitive hosting rates while maintenance attractive margins for the AEG.
With exposure to both AI hyperscalers and Bitcoin mining clients, how is AEG managing demand across these fast-moving sectors?
We structured our model to be the client agnostic with the infrastructure that support both AI training workloads and the blockchain validation. This dual demand profile would ensure high utilization across cycles and which help us to remain competitive in that particular market. AI capacity is growing exponentially the same way as the crypto mining.
Alexa, the announcement references a 300 megawatt pipeline. How much visibility do you have on that pipeline? And what are the key milestones that investors should track?
So the 300 megawatt pipeline is structured into the clear de-risk stages. The phase one is really clear. It's 8 MW, which is already in the construction right now. Phase two will take us to 33 megawatts as applications and approvals are already processed. The phase three moves us to 100 megawatts in the early 2026 with negotiations, which we are already handling on our new sites for the 60 megawatts. Beyond this, we have identified the multiple additional locations to scale towards 300 megawatts as well.
What does this mean for shareholders in terms of value creation and long-term growth?
So for the shareholders, the UAE rollout is transformational. The AEG is shifting from development stage renewables player into an owner of the mission-critical digital infrastructure with a constructed recurring revenues. So the models provide scalability, defensibility, and exposure of two of the fastest growing technology sectors globally. In the near term, each megawatt deployed enhances cash flow visibility. In the medium term, building towards 300 megawatts, positioning AEG as a regional infrastructure leader.
Alexa, I hope you'll continue to keep us updated with progress. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Thank you so much for having me.
You're very welcome. Aleksandra Tsybulskaya is General Manager for Active Energy Group in the UAE.